Hello everyone and welcome back to Dinkum. My name is Melanie P. Now this is episode 8 in our Sinola's Peat Bell series and it is going to be from the first day of winter and we'll go all the way up to the 7th day of winter. So in this peat bell we will be working on building a pyramid and that pyramid is going to be a jungle pyramid of sorts. But we're gonna start here on the first day of winter on a Sunday, and of course it's a Sunday, so we're going to the island. Now we've only got 40 keys, so we're only gonna be able to get 8 maps in total. And we're gonna start off on our helicopter, go exploring and find a shark. But of course we're gonna check out the coolers as well. We had to fly around for a tiny bit and then we found the shark, so we're gonna put in all of our keys and get 8 maps. And off we go to find our first treasure. That was fairly close by. Then it was on to treasure chest number 2. And here we are at chest number 3. What are we gonna find in number 4? And off we go to find number 5. That was pretty close. Okay, let's go check out number 6. And on to number 7 we go. And last but not least, let's go find treasure chest number 8. And since our treasure hunt was done, it was now time to just collect some resources. We mostly want some of those tree seeds, but we also want some of the different the summer lily seeds and pretty much anything else we can get. After a long day, it was time to go home. And this is going to be the site of our pyramid. The very first thing we need to do is get up to the top and just clear out all of the grass and trees. After we got everything all cleared, it was time to form the base of the pyramid. So we went up with some dirt printing as high as we possibly could. And now we can start on the shape. And whilst we let our dirt printer charge, it was time to kind of figure out a little bit more of the base of the pyramid. And the pyramid's going to be surrounded by water, so we're just kind of making a trench for where the water will be. Okay, now that the full base was done, it was time to free the water and let it fill up the surroundings of the pyramid. And now it was time to add the mossy brick path. Now it's just gonna leave a few random open spaces just to kind of represent some of the decay over time. And in the empty spots, I was just gonna fill it with randomly placed seeds. Mostly the summer lily seeds and the fern, so I went ahead and placed down a bunch of seeds. But I will end up regretting this tomorrow. After placing all those seeds, we decided to go to bed, which was a very bad decision because all of the seeds disappeared overnight. So we had to go secure some more resources the next day. Started in the pine forest first. We got some gumwood as well. Lots of gumwood seeds. We also did spend some time in the tropics collecting seeds. Then it was back, so I decided to fill in more of the pyramid with the mossy path and intermittently dispersed it with just some tropical grass seeds. And this time when I placed all these seeds, I decided I better make sure they're planted before we go to bed. Thank you. So in this section over here, I mostly just wanted to use pine cone and gumwood tree seeds, but then it was off to bed for the day. And we started the next day collecting some more resources. We needed more seeds, of course. So we got a bunch more gumwood seeds. Then went back to the tropics to get some fern seeds and some more palm tree seeds as well. You know, I was back to the pyramid. So I was gonna make the waterway a little bit erratic. Well, not erratic, just more uneven. So we had two levels. And we're just gonna fill in a whole bunch of different types of trees. And we're going to put some fern in here, some of the summer lily seeds too, some of the palm seeds and banana trees as well. Just a random assortment of trees. Now, this patch in the center here was meant to kind of represent a lower land bridge. I was constantly being harassed by that croc, so I had to take it out. And then it was finally time for bed, and I needed to get some of the giant lily pads, so we decided to head down to the undergrowth. And we went in search of marble, iron, but mostly it was for the giant lily pads. And after a long day in the mines, we headed back and we used the lily pads to build a land bridge. And next morning, we started on some fencing. And we just used the marble fencing because it had like the green in between the marble, which kind of looked like it meant to be in a jungle. So we just got the fencing outlining the outside of the pyramid. Thank you. And we've just about finished on our pyramid build here. Now, the area before the pyramid, I wanted to do some work there, so I laid down some fir grass. We wanted to kind of have a two separate areas, almost like two separate biomes. So partial tropical, and then it kind of merges into a pine forest. Yeah, and I decided to add another waterway. And we lined this waterway with a bunch of seaweed. And I'm gonna go through and add a bunch of random lily pads as well. And we added some more dark wood fencing around the perimeter. And then we added a tiny little bridge to get across the small tiny river. But now it's time for the tour. So we added a whole bunch of lighting on the outside. Two croco statues, because this area is guarded by crocs. And we thought we'd leave the random piece of debris that kind of feels like it's some sort of mystery surrounding the pyramid where the satellite fell into the pyramid. And here we are at the top. Okay, well, if you enjoyed this episode, please feel free to like and subscribe to the channel. But thank you very much for watching.